Good morning all of you, my dear students. In today's session, this is a part number 8 regarding to one word substitutes. In this part I will explain you in detail 10 one word substitutes, my dear students. Before going to start this class today, all of you requested to watch the entire video or complete video from the beginning to ending, my dear students. Here the first one is VER, VER, R is a silent, VER. What is the meaning of VER? VER means changing the direction of one's path suddenly. That path means a way or track or route. Path means R-O-U-T, route, a way or a track, the direction. And another meaning is the way of life, the way of conduct, the way of thought. That is the path. Here the way of direction, route. Changing the direction of one's path suddenly. That is the meaning of fear, my dear students. And we are means a sudden change of direction. If something veers in a certain direction, it suddenly moves. And in that direction, all of a sudden, for example, all of a sudden, what happened? The car veered off the road. The car veered off, past tense, it has been used as verb. Veered off the road, R-O-A-D, road. That means it has changed suddenly its direction. That is the meaning of that particular situation. And the usage is also given. The word, it has been used in this context as a verb. V2 verb, past form of the verb. He veered the car. That means a sudden change of direction. And change direction suddenly. In the other direction, as the deer came, deer, one of the animal, deer, came in the way. When the deer came in the way, the driver veered the car in the other direction. That means a sudden change of direction. That is the meaning of that particular usage and example sentence, my dear students. And then we discuss the next word, one word substitutes. The second word is saver. Saver, R is a silent, saver. Saver means enjoy something for an extended time. Enjoying something for an extended word, extended time. What is the meaning of extended time? Extended time means longer than expected. Longer than expected time, a definite time. Enjoy something we can enjoy. That is savor. Savor means taste. A good food or drink. And enjoy it to the full. That is a savor. We enjoy good food. We enjoy good drink. A characteristic taste or flavor FLAVO your flavor. Savor means flavor. A flavor or smell is especially a pleasant one, pleasant smell. PLESANT, pleasant smell. And to enjoy food or an experience slowly in order to enjoy. It is as much as possible. That means as much as possible we enjoy eating food because it is a savor or enjoying or tasting, it is a flavor. To pleasure from something, that is the meaning. To enjoy something for a long time, that is the savor, long time. That is the meaning of the savor, one of the usages as given. Don't forget to savor, it has been used to infinitive. To savor, 2 plus V1, to infinitive. Don't forget to savor this delectable wine. A delectable wine. What is the meaning of delectable? Delectable means delicious. Delicious, D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S, delicious. Delicious food or delicious drink. That means looking or tasting or lasting extremely good and giving great pleasure. That is the meaning of delectable wine. And don't forget to savor this delectable wine means delicious wine. To enjoy food or experience slowly and to pleasure from something, to enjoy something for a long time. For example, I savored my meal. One more example I will give you. I savored. SAVORED. It has been used as a verb. I savored my meal or my lunch. My lunch. Savored means I have eating, I am having the food, tasting or smelling with pleasure, and enjoy as much as possible. Experience slowly in order to enjoy. That is the meaning of that one. One more meaning is there, savor. Savor means delight. Delight means happy. That is another meaning, delight, D-E-L-I-G-H-T, delight. Merry, happy. The team savored its victory. When they won the match, the team savored. Savored means they are delighted. They are happy. That is another meaning. And then we go to the next word. One word substitutes. Important one word substitute. It has been asked many competitive and academic examination. A scapegoat. It is a third one. It is a third one of one word substitute in this class, my dear student. Scapegoat. What's the meaning of scapegoat? Someone who is wrongly blamed. Actually, he is not doing any wrong for things that others have done. He is responsible for others' mistakes. He was blamed. He was criticized. He was suffered. He suffered from others' mistakes. He is called a scapegoat. That means a person who is blamed for the wrongdoings, mistakes, or faults of others. Faults of others, not himself. A person who is blamed for something that someone else has done, not himself, someone else has done. That is the meaning of the scapegoat, my dear students. Scapegoat, for example, a bad workman blames his tools. Tools actually very perfect, but he is not able to do that work. That's why he blames the tools. इट इज़ वन ऑफ द इडियम ए बैड वर्कमैन ए बैड वर्कमैन वॉट डज ही से ब्लेम्स हिज टूल्स ब्लेमिंग द टूल्स द टूल्स आर वेरी परफेक्ट बट ही इज नॉट एबल टू डू नथिंग ऑन द टाइम द टूल्स हैव बीन scapegoat फॉर एग्जाम्पल The captain of the team was made a scapegoat for the team's failure. If the team has been failed, not winning, the captain was blamed. The team of the captain was blamed. That means he was made a scapegoat. That is the usage of my students. Example sentence. One more example sentence. Here the sentence is, for instance, they used him as a scapegoat. They blamed one of the person as a scapegoat. Why? Because to accuse him of the whole conspiracy. To accuse a person or group of people who are charged for a crime. To accuse him. Of the whole conspiracy. Conspiracy means, what is the meaning of conspiracy? A secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or harmful. Conspiracy, plot. But means here the meaning is they used him as a scapegoat. All the persons have blamed his friend, only one person, to accuse him of the whole conspiracy. That person was blamed, that person was responsible. But actually he is not only one person. Many persons has been involved. Only one has been as a scapegoat to accuse him of the whole conspiracy. That is the meaning. He is the victim. He is a scapegoat means victim. He is a victim. That is the meaning of that particular scapegoat. It is an important word. And the next word is a tannery. The next word is a tannery. What is the next word? One word substitutes. This one is called tannery. T-A-N-N-E-R-Y. Tannery. What's the meaning of tannery? Here the explanation has given space or place. Or venue where animal hides, animal skins are tanning. Animal skin. Our tanning is called tannery. A tannery is the place where skins are processed. P-R-O-C-E-S-S-E-D, process. Where skins are processed, that is called tannery. A place, an area, or a venue, or space, where skins are processed, that is called tannery. Tanning is the process of, what is the meaning of tanning? Tanning is the process of treating and hides of the animals or skins of the animals to produce leather. L-E-A-T-H-E-R, leather. A place where leather is made, that is the tannery. A place where leather, L-E-A-T-H-E-R, leather is made or manufactured. That is called tanning. That is the tannery, a place where leather is made, a place where skins and hides are tanned, the workshop of a tanner. There is an extensive sole leather, the undersurface of a person's foot, sole, S-O-L-E, sole, sole leather. Sole leather means, under surface of the foot. The tannery means a place where skins and hides are to be tanned. the workshop of a tanner, there is a place where leather is made. A place where leather is made is called tannery. And then usage is given. The leather for this coat has been skinned in the tannery. It has processed. The processing of skin is called tanning. Where tanning is takes place, that particular area is called, that particular building is called tannery. The leather for this coat has been skinned in the tannery. That is the explanation, my dear students. Tannery means. And then next, we go to the next one word substitutes. What is the next one word substitutes? We change the screen. And then, it is the one word substitutes. This is the fifth one in this session, in this class. T-E-N-A-C-I-O-U-S. Tenacious. The pronunciation is tenacious. 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 Here the second syllable has been tested. Tenacious. That is the correct pronunciation. Tenacious. What's the meaning of tenacious? Determined to achieve something. Determined. Determination. A strong desire to achieve something is called determination. That does not stop holding or something to give up something easily. Holding tightly onto something. Keeping an opinion in a determined way. That type of quality, positive quality, good quality, pleasant quality. Tenacious. It is an adjective. Here, tenacious means continuing to exist. Have influence for longer than use. And it is persistent. P-E-R-S-I-S-T-N-T. Persistent. Persistent means continuing to exist or occur over a prolonged period. We are striving tenaciously means if you are tenacious, we are very determined and do not give up easily. That is the meaning of tenacious, good quality. Tenacious means determination, dedication, persistent, continuing, prolonged period to exist, continuing to exist. That is the meaning of tenacious. And keeping an opinion in a determined way. For example, she is a tenacious. She is a tenacious. She is a tenacious. N-A-C-I-O-U-S. A strong, determined woman. She is a tenacious. She never give up. She never give up. She never gives up or gave up. That type of woman she is, tenacious, persistent woman. He behaves tenaciously. That is the meaning of the tenacious. She is very tenacious and will work hard and long to achieve objectives, a goal or aim. She is very tenacious means you work hard and you strive for a long time to achieve his aim and target. That is a good quality, tenacious. One of the usages given. She was tenacious enough to chase after a dream of becoming a film actor. If she wanted to become a film actor, in his career, in his life, he has decided, he wanted to become a film actor. That's why she was tenacious, continuous effort enough to chase after her dream of become. The dream of, what is the dream? He will become a film actor. That's why he has improved the quality of tenacious. That means a persistent quality. Continuing to exist or occur over a period of time, a prolonged time to achieve that is a dream. to become a film actor. That is the usage, my students. And then the next word is screech. It is regarding to sounds by the animals or objects or things. Actually, the sound of parrot is talk, T-A-L-K, talk. This screech, the screech sound has been produced. It is a screech means a give a loud, harsh, piercing cry. A loud, harsh, piercing to make an unpleasant sound, screech means. Loud, high noise, N-O-I-S, loud, high noise. Actually, this word has been used, screech sound. And this sound has produced, parrots, the sound of parrot is talking. The screech means a long, loud, high noise that is unpleasant to hear. For example, the car screeched to a halt. For example, I will give one of these. The car screeched. The car screeched to halt. To halt means stop. That means it stopped very suddenly, making a loud, harsh noise. Screeched means. This is the usage, correct usage. The car screeched to halt means the car stopped very suddenly, making a loud, high noise. That is the context. That is the right context, my dear students. And then next word is usage has been given. I woke up to the screeching of birds. Some birds, screeching birds by the window. I woke up due to the sound of that. Because of the birds are screeching near the window, I woke up. Wake. I woke up. Past tense form of the word. I woke up from the bed. I got up to the screeching of the birds by the window. Some other meaning also. He let out to a loud screech. It is not only for the animals and the birds, but it is also applied to the human being. Some of the persons who is very angrily person, he let out a loud speech, a long, loud, high noise that is unpleasant to hear, to cry out loudly and emotionally. My father screeched out. That means he cry out loudly and emotionally. For example, the sounds of the brake, B-R-A-K, brakes. The truck stopped with a screeches of brakes. The sounds of the brake is called a screech. Okay, next word. Next one word substitute is M-I-S-N-O-M-E-R. What is the meaning of M-I-S? The pronunciation is, the correct pronunciation, misnomer. Misnomer means misnomer. What is the meaning of misnomer? Misnomer using a word or name that is inappropriate, not appropriate, not suitable. Inappropriate. It is antonym of appropriate. Not suitable, inappropriate. Not related. That is a misnomer. Misnomer means a wrong or incorrect name or designation. Incorrect, inappropriate, a wrong or incorrect use of a name or term. T-E-R-M, term. A name or term. The definition of the misnomer is giving the wrong name for a person, giving the wrong name for a thing, giving the wrong name for a place also, not a person, thing or place. It is called misnomer. A use of a wrong or inappropriate name. inapplicable name, inapplicable title, inapplicable term, incorrect, unsuitable name, that is called misnomer. It is also called pseudonym or misnaming, alias. This is the meaning of the misnomer, my dear students. And usage is given, it is quite a misnomer to call it a victory since he scored the lowest marks in the test. How do you call a victory? He gets lowest marks in the test. It is a misnomer, incorrect, inappropriate, unsuitable, inaccurate. It is a wrong concept. Highest marks in the test, you got a victory. It is quite a misnomer to call it a victory since he scored the lowest marks in the test. Misnomer means inappropriate. And then next word is monarchy. Next one word substitute is monarchy. What is the monarchy? Monarchy is a government system that is a ruling. That is a monarch as the head. Monarch, what is the meaning of monarch? Monarch is such a king or a queen. King or queen, Q-U-E-N, queen. Rules a kingdom. He is called monarch. There is no democracy, opposite of democracy. Monarchy, such a king or a queen rules a kingdom. The system of having a king or queen, a state or nation in which the supreme power actually lodged in a monarch. The entire power has been situated in the hands of the monarch, not a democratic system. He is a sovereign head of state, especially a king or queen or emperor for the kingdom. Are a king or a queen. That is the meaning. It is a system or form of the government. A country that is ruled by a monarch, that is called monarchy. With a king ruling the country, the monarchy is different from democracy. Democracy is a public representatives, people's representatives who are ruling the kingdom or country. And with a king ruling the country, the monarchy is different from a democracy, entirely different. The powers distributed among the public representatives in the democracy, but monarchy has, he captured entire power, supreme power in only one king, one person. That is the usage, my dear students. And then we go to the next word, grunt. What is the meaning of the grunt? GRU. It is also related to the sounds, regarding to sounds of animals. The sounds of animals, camels also produce, the sound of camel is also grunt, and pig also. The sound produced by the pig is called grunt. Animal, especially pig, make a low, short, guttural sound. To make a low, rough noise, R-O-U-G-H, rough noise, N-O-S-E, rough noise. The pigs were grunting as they were having food. The pigs were grunting as they were having food. This is one of the usage, grunt. Not only for the animals, but also for the human beings you are also using. Grunt person means to make a short, low sound instead of speaking usually. Because of anger and pain. When the person is anger and pain, he is grunted. He grunted and sat down. This word is also used in the context of the human beings also. While the human being is very angry with the anger and pain, he grunted and sat down. He granted. If you grunt, we make a low sound because we are annoyed or not interested in something. On that context, we are using for the human being. Actually, the sounds of camels, the sounds of the pigs is called grunt, my dear students. And then usage. The vastness of the desert, the only sound you can hear is the constant grunting of camels from far away. In the desert, which is the animal is living, the animal which is frequently living, camel is, the sound of the camel is grunt, constant grunting of camels from far away. Where do you hear? In the desert, vastness of desert, a big area of the desert, the only sound you can hear. Here is the constant grunting of camels from the far away. That is the one of the usage. And the last one in this clause is F-I-E-S-T-A. What is the pronunciation? F-I-E-S-T-A. The pronunciation of this word is fiesta. Fiesta. Fiesta means festivals. Events manifested by festivals. Festival means festival. A religious festival. A fiesta is a celebration or a party or a festival. A celebration. We can use the word fiesta for any party. We can use any party, any festival, any celebration. But it is usually refers to a large fiesta festival. Festival or very extravagant party, large, L-A-R-G, large festival. Or very extravagant party is called fiesta. A public celebration, especially one on a religious holiday with different types of entertainment or activities. A big festive mood is called fiesta. It is a feast, it is a mela, M-E-L-A, mela. It is a gala day means happy day, enjoying day. That is called fiesta. It is a festive or joyful, merry feast, a public celebration or a party. It is called a fiesta. And then the use, last night's party was a total fiesta. Total fiesta means we have enjoyed, we have celebrated in a festive mood or joyful mood or merry way. It is a public celebration. It is a large entertainment activities. This is called extravagant party. Large feast or large festival. It is a large party. Last night's party was a total fiesta. That is the usage, my dear students, example sentence. Okay, my dear students. I have completed 10 one-word substitutes in this class. This is the 7th part. I have completed nearly 70 one-word substitutes. In each part, I have explained 10 one-word substitutes. Okay, thank you everybody. Once again, all of you, goodbye.